Hello everyone, welcome back to tybmmlife.com. Today we are going to talk about fonts. The second most important aspect of designing a newspaper or a magazine is the font selection. There are several types of fonts that are available, but we are going to classify the fonts into only two categories. They are serif and sans-serif. So, what is serif and sans-serif? So, let's draw a text box. Let's draw a text box and type in something. So, let's type in www.tybmmlife.com. Select the font. This font in particular is completely flat. The thickness of each stroke is even. I'll tell you what I mean by even. Now, if we type in this thing again, and if we choose some other font maybe, right? This is a good example. So this font does not have even strokes. One stroke is thick, followed by a thin stroke, thick, thin, thick, thin. This is a characteristic of serif fonts, and this is a sans-serif font. These little edges that you see here, they're called serifs. And sans in Latin means without. So without serif is sans-serif. They don't have these edges here. Serif and sans-serif have their own positives and negatives. For one, serif fonts have a certain width to them, certain depth to them, and sans-serif fonts are bold, they are loud, they are outspoken. In a scenario of designing a magazine or a newspaper, you would use serif fonts when you want the reader to whiz through the article. So serif fonts are mostly used in the body of the article, and sans-serif fonts are used when you want to make a loud statement. So headlines is the place where you use a sans-serif font. Having a fixed boldness to it emphasizes the weight of the sans-serif fonts. This width, this thickness is called line weight. The boldness of the stroke is called line weight, or you can even call it stroke weight. So when you have even stroke weight, it is sans-serif. When you have uneven stroke weight, you have serifs. Serif and sans-serif make a very huge impact on the quality of design that you create in your newspaper. They play a very, very important role in creating the great tonal values when you design the newspaper. We'll come back to that in the next lesson. Thank you.